and they collected all the men in there. They shot them. They have a machine gun and they killed them, all of them.
And they killed everyone. They opened fire for all people.
Most of Khan Yunis' men killed in that day. More than 700 people killed in that day. All of the children there became orphans.
My name is Nasri. Nasri Ahmed Hassan Ali Abdo. I was born in Yafa.
Muhammad Khalid Abu Mahmoud. I was born in Yafa.
Naif Muhammad Mahmoud Hajjaj. Born in Alma.
Saeed Muhammad Al-Isawi. I born in Al-Jalazoon camp.
My name Atif Karim. I born in Palestine in Hamidiya.
Mahmoud Muhammad Sultan. I born in Jaffa City in November 1944.
My name is Adnan Abdel Fattah. I was born in the village of Burqa, Nablus, March 1945. So that makes me about 3 years, more than 3 years, older than the State of Israel, which was May 1948.
I was born in our Biyara. Biyara means farm. My father and my mom and the rest of the family of my father all living in the house together in our Biyara.
My dad and mom were living in a small village, but it is about 6 to 7 kilometers far away from the sea. And they were having about 40 kilo or 4 to 6 acres in their area.
When I was 3.5 years old, Ben-Gurion declared about establishing Israel in Palestine.
When I was born, there was always a bit of conflict because always we see people being kicked from their homes or leave the homes, they come back to their home and somebody else took the place and they have no right in it.
So when I was very little, I remember my father staying home all the time, most of the time, because what happened in 1948, there was a Nakba. People were kicked out of their houses in Palestine, and some were kicked out of their jobs in Palestine.
In 1948, the Jewish settlers start bombing Jaffa from everywhere, and the people of Jaffa haven't any weapon to defend themselves.
I remember that the Israeli forces, they came to us and they bombarded us by planes and by tanks by the Israeli forces.
The people of Jaffa, they run from place to place under this pressure. They start to push us by force. In the beginning, they use the guns and they use tanks. But when we reach around the port, they start to bomb us from plane.
They started to escape to the beach of Jaffa, to escape by the sea to Gaza Strip and to Lebanon. And there is ready Greek ships waiting to help them to escape to Gaza and Lebanon.
They separated the two groups, right and left. The people on the right, they later, under the force, they moved in direction of West Bank, and some people of them stay in Qilia.
When the Israelis occupied our city, our village, Kfar Ana, my dad was outside the village. He was with the fighters, with the resistance men of Palestine. My mother, with small children, they left the city, the village.
When the Israeli go into Deir Yassin and Kfar Qasim and kill all the people, and we get scared, they start to drop a Bible. They ask us to leave from here, from the village. And of course, the people get scared and left the village and go and they ask they leave for 1 week. After that, you come back. And we didn't come back anyhow. We were going to Jordan.
When we come back from the beach to our home, my father asked me to ask about what happened to our neighbors. And first home, Saadoni family, they killed 3 brothers. And one of them, he held his child and he said to the soldier, to Israeli soldiers, please don't kill me for the sake of this child. He said, you and your child. His child leg cut from the end and he died. And when I go to their home, I saw their bodies still in the home. They go to the other homes. Most of Khan Yunis men killed in that day. More than 700 people killed in that day. All of the children there became orphans. It's a big massacre. They killed the men of Khan Yunis city and they collected them in groups, every group between 30 and 40 person, and they are ordered them to look to the wall and they shoot all of them.
There is auntie of my father. She live in the area of Jaffa, but I don't remember exactly the town. The Jews came to the town and they killed everyone. They opened fire for all people. All people there pass away except two. Her brother, old one, and her son.
Before I left Palestine, they were the Israeli scare us. They make Deir Yassin. They kill most of the people there. In Kfar Qasim, they kill all the people. The another village, they get scared. The everyone, every father, he want to take his kids and go out till the war is finished.
They came in the morning and they killed all the men. They collected all the men in the area. And there is a big area in Alma. And they collected all the men in there. And they killed all the people, all the men there. They shoot them. They have a machine gun. And they killed them, all of them. In front of everybody, yes. I was witnessing there, yes.
My friend, Abdullah Hamouda, he was 12 years old at the time. He was in a group. His teacher, Mr. Alam Al-Alami, beside him, he said to him when they ordered them to look to the wall, he said to his teacher, they will kill us. He said, don't be scared. Come in front of me. And he put him in front of him and they start shooting him. Most about 35 persons killed. Still, Muhammad still alive. When the killers moving in their car, he tried to get up. His leg is broken. He can't get up. And he's still moving on his back until he reaches their home. And their neighbor fixed his leg until he go to the hospital. And he came to the school with six. And that still in my mind from that time, I can't forget. I'm still suffering until now from what happened to our people in Khan Yunis city.
Jaffa people, we have our registered of our biyarat or our lands over there. Up to now, I have it. It is kept in one bank here. I kept all the document given from my father to me, which is our wealth in Jaffa. They stolen the land, they stolen the things. Yeah, but the document with us, inshallah, in the future, when we back to our country, we can use it.
We have a house in Jaffa, house and land in Jaffa, not far from the water. It's called Hay Nuzha. When I went the last two times there, our land was not occupied by anybody. And there was a white blue strap surrounding it like a fence. It wasn't a fence, just a strap. They can demolish it, but I don't know why they left it, and other houses as well for other people. They're all strapped with a blue strip, and they just kept empty.
After 1 year, they came to the camp and they informed the manager of the camp to call my father. And they came and sat with him from 8 morning up to 2 afternoon. They asked him about many things. Then my dad, in a very smart manner, simple way, he said, yes, you are talking that I am sick, I am old, and you want to give me the money for my land to have fun. What I will do in that money, I might die tomorrow, after a month, a year. Allah knows, God knows. So why I will sell my land and take that money and throw it? I don't want to sell my land. I will keep it for my children such that they can utilize it. He was thinking that we will return back to our homeland in Jaffa, Kfar Ana, shortly. He was expecting something, liberation will happen. But he died in 1971.
Well, I was all my life dreaming to go back to Palestine. Till this time. Before 5 years, I take my kids. I have 3 sons. I go with them together to Palestine to show him our land, our house in Palestine. And the Israeli, they all farm man. They take our land and they work there. When they see the car, the man is come. He stopped. He said, what are you looking for? I said, well, I born in here in Hamidiya. And where is Hamidiya? They changed about 70 years. His father came to Palestine and he born in here. And they kicked me from my house and my land. And yeah.
So when I remember that, I really shocked. I really become very upset. My land is with others who came from around the world and not allow us to go back. And that's how the Israelis create their, what they say, country. But inshallah, we will go back one day.
For the young ones, never forget, your freedom is in your heart. Don't be ever scared from anybody when you say the right word or the truth. Because this way, the truth will never die. And if it does with you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to revive it again.
All what I need now, if I can't go back, or my Palestine to be free in my lifetime, to be free for my daughters and my grandchildren.
If Palestine get back to us, I never stay here 24 hours. First one, I go to Palestine, and I die in Palestine. This is from my side. We love our country.
It's very hard to leave your home by force. And we still remembering our, I still remember my home in Jaffa. I was 3.5 years old, but I still remember the home and the farm. And I hope to come back, but it's not easy. It's not easy to come back because we haven't the power. But we hope in the future we'll grandsons and have more power to go back to their homeland. And the God promised us with victory, and the victory will come. Will come anytime. The victory will come, and we will return to Palestine.